Hey boys and girls, Mike here, one go short play, and today we are playing the adventures of Lolo on the NES. Ooh, an adventure is about to happen. Someone's being carried away. Quite a nice angle, isn't it, for a neat bit game. Bit dynamic. That's not so. We get it. It's Bomberman, Dino Blaster intro, and Amiga. Same sort of thing. Off to the castle we go. Ghosts and goblins, you know the score. Someone's been kidnapped. We're going to rescue them. We're called Lolo. We're clearly some kind of blue M&M. It's all good. Sorry about the mess, by the way. I've just realised all this is in shop. It's Joe's bedroomy stuff. Look, there's those. See the elf, the corner of the elf? There's that Nintendo colour clash again. Is it three colours? Answers on a postcard if you know. Is it a three-colour limit in the 8x8 squares? I think it is. I know working on Game Boy Advance was a 16-colour limit, I think, in the 8x8 squares, which of course means that you're pretty sorted as long as you don't have to deal with palettes. And that was good fun, making games on that. I'd love to have a go at making an NES game. It's all got the palettes, the colour palette. Maybe I should look into that. I don't know what happened there. I just died for no reason. Oh. Select as a suicide button. I'm not happy about that. The other buttons, they do nothing. Want that? No, don't. Okay. I appear to be in a top-down puzzle situation in which that snake will kill me if I touch it. After that, right in the face, I've got a feeling I shouldn't have put that there. No, it's all good. Oh, that's nice. The bubble bobble element where you escape from your little egg bubble thing. After a certain amount of time, that's cool. And the door opens. It's a bit Bomberman too. this is a combination of a lot of games, a lot of old games. The hearts give you weapons by the looks of it. No, maybe not. And it's a combination of those games actually quite well executed. And that mechanic where you push stuff about, which I always hated because it was always done badly in Amiga PD games. Amiga owners, you know what I'm talking about. And it was always overdone, and it was always not very fun. Uh-oh, they've come to life. Oh, I should have seen that coming. I kind of did. a lot of love and thought has gone into this. I'll give it that. They've thought through those enemies. They've thought through all these different mechanics that they're using together. Maybe I should not pick this one at last. Right, go, little M&M, go. See, if I do that, look, I don't think so, my friend. See ya. Really, if I was that dinosaur monster and I was that intent on killing the little blue M&M, I wouldn't just stand there shooting in one direction, I'd, like, go him. And if you're going to make it an obstacle, don't make it a live obstacle, because it's got no intelligence. Stupid, I know, I'm just nitpicking. I'm like the nerd kid at school who breaks down every element of something good and... Uh-oh, I'm not happy about that guy. I am not happy about that guy, I think I've got to act fast. Oh no. Oh no, I'm stuck! I've got myself in a bind. Can't get through there. Can I smash the rocks? Is it going to get a bit boulder dash? No. We are in trouble. I just can't get past them. Oh, and that annoys me. I'm in a situation now of my own making. Albeit, actually that's why I got suicide button. never liked games that do that. There's a lot I don't like about this game, I'll be honest. And it's that it uses so many of the tropes. Oh, you can kick that. Okay. And I'm stuck again. Oh, I don't like that little blue square. They use so many of the features of other puzzly retro games, some of which I like, some of which I don't. What I find there is the ones that I don't like take the fun away from the ones that I like. And it doesn't make for a brilliant game. It's a mediocre game. Adventures of Lolo, NES. Thanks for watching.